Islamorada, Florida, the Middle Keys, 81.5 mile marker on the ocean side. And this is the Morada Way Art and Cultural District, and we're right in the heart of it right down here. A vast amount of the general public comes out. Along with all the vendors and local businesses, you'll have the gentleman that owns the local liquor store will come and set up, the local restaurant they'll come and set up, and they might have some tidbits and some wares, and everybody's gonna showcase. It's not over commercial in that way, because they're not selling. They're very generous. They don't even come here to sell stuff. They came here just to meet everybody and say, hey, my store might be down the road. Have you been in lately? That might be part of it. Do a lot of gratis. Everybody sets up. If they're not for profit, they just set up anyway. So we encourage all the artists to come out. I do performance art mostly for fundraising efforts. And I will start painting while people are doing their fundraising efforts and the dinners. And by the time the dinner's done and the auction starts, I'm signing it. And we usually live auction that piece. And I'll give the brush I signed it with right then and there to the people, and the paint's still wet.
We try to have the art move. We have people performing and showing you how they do their art. We have a young fellow named Joaquin who's a street artist who does spray can art. We have a guy who actually does a sculpture live. We have a guy who turns pottery in front of you and then completes the whole process and teaches about it. Our mission is to teach about art. If we can have people doing it on the street, doing it live, so you can see it happen, we're fulfilling our mission.
The artist community here is very relaxed, and we're all very supportive of each other, and there's a little competition, but we're mostly supportive of each other, and we're all good friends, so that's what I really love about this community in particular, and especially Morada Way Arts District. Very vibrant colors. I think that's my little niche in the painting world. These are actually only the eyes of the fish. In just doing the eyes, I've given them a little bit of personality. That's another thing that I think makes my art a little bit different.
I'm an abstract artist, so I do impressions of what I think about.
We wanted all the colors to be in this piece. If we put it on one panel, it's got to be on another panel somewhere else. That was kind of the rule.
The moon actually was a happy accident. So it's just little things that kept on happening that just, you know, we didn't anticipate things like that happening.
It's really unique because we get a lot of tourists, but as well as locals. The locals come here to be able to create, as well as, you know, purchase a lot of local art.
It's all just celebrating the arts. A lot of people sign up for the pottery classes and the painting classes, and so it's a place to be inspired and act on that inspiration.
Figured if we did one night for the community where they could just forget about what it is they do during the day and come out and relax and meet friends, have a glass of wine in the middle of the road and listen to some music, that would just be a great venue. And it's been all that and more.